Hello everyone and welcome to Drika Styles. It is your girl Shandrika here back with another video finally. I'll be showing you how I define my coils. Yes, I did take some scissors to the hair, and I did a little big chop again and I am enjoying my curls. All right, so I'm going to show you how I get these curls to pop like they are. So make sure you get all of the products that I have so you can have the same results. Sometimes you don't get the same results if you are high porosity or low porosity. I'm low porosity, and these are the products that I use, okay? But you can just do whatever works for you. But it's really about the technique. You're going to need your Denman brush. No matter what products you use, you're going to need your Denman brush. All right? So that is how you're going to get your curls to pop. And there's another trick. You have to watch to see how I get it like this. So you can't be fast-forwarding through. So after I curl it up and let it dry, you'll see what I do to make the curls come out more so like this. All right, so I hope you all enjoyed the video. Go ahead and click the subscribe button and keep watching. Okay guys, let's get straight into the video. This is what I decided to use on my hair, which I always use, the Curl Enhancing Smoothie by Shea Moisture, Green Gel, the Edge Booster, and that is the extra strength one. For these edges, I need extra strength. And here's the other gel that I used. And I use the matching shampoo and conditioner from Shea Moisture as well. My Denman brush, I always have my shears just in case I need to cut some ends off, and those clips. So yes, that's what I use. And yes, I mix these two gels together. And to me, it just makes my curls pop more. So let's get started. Okay, y'all, so we're gonna continue on with the style. As you can see, I am detangling my freshly washed and deep conditioned hair. And I love to start from the roots. I mean, not from the roots. I like to start from the ends and work my way to the roots. And usually I would section my hair, but I didn't do it now because I knew I was about to section it for this style. But that probably would have made it easier. But anyway, I'm just going to proceed to parting it off now. And I'm going to do these sections because it really helps me when I'm styling my hair. So I am not sure why I could not get my full head inside the shot, but I kept trying to do landscape and it just would not let me. So hopefully the next video is better than this one. So as you can see, I'm parting the top off and we're gonna do that part. That's the third section, I would say. We're going to do the two sides first, and then we're going to do the middle section. So I'm just parting around where I want my hair to kind of come forward, because usually if I'm rushing, I would just put the curls in there, curl my hair up. But having sections, it really put everything in perspective for your hairstyle. So you have to have your Denman brush and brush it through, and you have to have wet hair. So this is my Curl Enhancing Shea Butter from Shea Moisture, my Curl Enhancing Smoothie. And as you can see, I was very generous. I actually had to take a towel and wipe some of that off. That was too much. And actually, don't use a towel. It made that side very, very frizzy after I did that. And I was like, I'm not going to do the rest of my hair. Use a t-shirt. So, or something, not a towel, because it's going to make your hair frizz. And I already knew that, but the towel was right there, so I just grabbed it. And for this style, you don't really want any frizz. So I just skipped that section because it gave me a hard time and I wanted to show you all how to do it properly. But this is it right here. And as you can see, the white stuff, it is the Curl Enhancing Smoothie. But I just have to make sure my hair is moisturizing. You have to get in there. As you saw in the previous clip, you have to get in there. People say they have white residue. I have never had white residue with Curl Enhancing Smoothie and these two gels. Never. So if you're just coating your hair with the Curl Enhancing Smoothie and not rubbing it in like I was just doing, thoroughly, then you probably will have residue. Your hair, the moisture is not penetrating. The product isn't penetrating all the way. So you want to make sure you do that. It's very important. So now I'm just taking a Denman brush after I've added gel, and I am turning the Denman brush upward. And so as you can see, my hair is starting to coil up. And so from what the Denman brush does, you'll see in this next clip, I just separate the curls from the curls that the Denman brush already made. The Denman brush is awesome for this style. You have to have one in order to achieve this look. I like to separate the curls that the dimmer brush made, and then twist the curl around my finger, if that makes sense. So you can just leave the curl from the dimmer brush. I've done that more so when I'm rushing, but if I have time, I will definitely take the time and twist it around my finger. Once again, I am going to take the dimmer brush and wrap the hair around like a curling iron. And then I just use my hand to smooth it on through. And you see how the dimmer brush separated my coils? I just love it. That brush is amazing. And yeah, so I just twirl it around my finger to get the coil that I want. And like I said, sometimes I do that and sometimes I don't. It just depends on my mood or where I'm going, what my daily activity is that day. All right, so we're just moving up, and lots of times I like to part with my finger. I'm not using a comb. I try to keep as much out my hair as I can. I'm already using a dimming brush, and I'm sure I'm going to get a few strings in that brush, So I don't want the comb in there as well. And there we go, just smoothing it on through and twisting it around your finger. Sometimes I use my middle finger and my pointer finger. It just depends, but it would be good if you want consistent curls all the way around to use the same finger for the whole head. And now we're just working our way up, and just be careful with the dimming brush because you don't want to brush too much. And I was generous with the gel. I was not trying to save gel for later. I did mix the two gels to achieve this look. And I just love how the curls come out like that for me. Okay, now this section, it could be slightly tricky, but not really. So all I'm going to do is just start this row. And yes, I think I say this later in the video, how sharp my hair is in the front, because I thought I took my crochet braids out the right way. But when I unbraided my hair, and that part in the front was like an inch, and it has grown this much. So I'm glad. I think that was in January. So January or March, I can't remember, but I'm glad to have some type of hair right here. So yeah, I just love how it coils up. So now with this row here, with this section, once you clip that out the way, what you want to do is first, the moisturizer is already on it, and make sure all of your sections are moisturized really well. I won't say too good, but enough, maybe like a dime size bit of moisturizer. So I'm just putting that dimming brush up, rolling it like a curling iron, and then for this part you want to kind of put the hair on the sides, like right there, that section, try to cover that part. And you're going to do that for this whole row. All of the end pieces that you're going to twirl, they're going to cover that part unless you want a side part. And so some people tell me that I don't pronounce my T's all the way, but I am saying a side part. I just don't pronounce, being from New Orleans, I guess we just don't pronounce the ending of our words. So yeah, the further I go up here, I'm going to do the same technique and try to force those curls to cover the parts. And the parts will only be covered. So that's why I said I can wear a side part on either side. That's why I like to part my hair and do it like this. So anytime I'm like, okay, I don't want the fro look, I just want like a side part. My husband loves when my hair is parted on the left side. So I wear it like that a few times a week, you know, so he can just have his little thing he like. But most of the time I am a fro girl, and I just like it as a fro. But I do like the side part and how I had it at the intro of this video. I thought that was really cute. But today I'm just really showing you how to get these coils. I'm not really styling it like I had it, but like I said, all I did was put the hair over. And I'll give you a few styles at the end of this video, so stay tuned. You see how I'm covering the parts here? I don't know if you could really see what all my mistakes I was making, but with editing. Boy, when I tell y'all, I just wanted to throw the phone today because I just could not get the editing right. And that's why I'm so inconsistent on my channel. I think of editing and I say, never mind. And as you can see, I curled that right on with that brush and covered the part because that part is longer anyway, so it's gonna automatically cover the parts anyway. And you want to make like medium-sized coils. Don't do it too small, and you don't want to do it too big. But remember at the beginning of the video, I was telling you to watch the video all the way through because in a few minutes, I'm gonna show you after I'm done with my whole head the key to get like a fuller look. So you're gonna need those medium-sized curls to achieve that. So y'all keep watching. It's lots of twirling, and you may have to stop because your arm is going to hurt. I did arms all week, and when I tell you, oh my goodness, my arms were hurting, they were. But in real time, this usually takes me about 25 to 30 minutes. Of course, it took me a little longer because I was recording, but I usually do this quite fast. Now we're just moving on to the back. And the back of my hair is way healthier than the front, but I know that's because of weaves and wigs. So I'm trying to do a month, y'all. Trying to do a month with no wigs or weaves. Well, I already put on a wig yesterday for Isaiah's band concert, so I didn't mess up with that. But I'm trying to do no weaves. Y'all think I could do it? Y'all know I love my weaves. But yeah, under those weaves, make sure you're keeping your hair nice and healthy. And it's up to you if you want to twist your hair all one way. Usually I do, but for some of this video, I did find myself twisting to the right and to the left. But I do think curls come out so much better when they all twisted the same way. I tried twirling the dimming brush under, and the curls does nothing for me. It's not even a curl. I don't, it's just wave up a little. So I know my hair likes this. And that was just me shaking it out. And now we're about to do our edges. And so when you shake your hair out, it just kind of gives it a little bounce as it dries. It won't be stiff. So make sure you do that. That's a very important step. And I can still flip, do cartwheels, and do handstands on the wall. So I just stay upside down for a little bit. I know it sounds weird. And it's also good to promote hair growth when your blood rush to your head. I know it all sounds crazy, but as a master cosmetologist, I'm telling you it is true and it works. Some people do it once a day, some people do it once a week. But I do it every time I do my hair. I don't know how long I'm gonna be able to cartwheel, so. But yeah, I have to get my edges straight. Y'all know I am an edge girl. You don't have to pull out too much, but with short hair, I just feel like pulling out your bangs, it really shapes your face. Hi guys, it is morning and this is what I did to wrap my hair up last night. Just put this scarf on. Actually, I just came down the stairs and my husband was like, oh, I like that. And I was like, what? Oh, so my hair is smashed. I did mess up my edges. So I have to redo those. And this is what my hair is looking like. I decided to let it air dry today. I mean, yesterday. I didn't want to put the blow dry on it to try to help the process. But I did go walk the belt line a little bit. And it rained some. So this is still nice to say that. I got a little drizzle drizzle. So yeah, so now what I'm going to do is take some of these curls apart. So I'll show you how I do that. You can go section by section, or like you see this one here, it looks pretty full and juicy. I really hate to separate it, but when you separate your hair, you just separate it all the way to like the tip, like that, but don't pull it all the way and just let it be. So you're not going to separate it all the way to the end till it comes apart. You're just going to separate it just till it get like to the end right there, and you just let it go. So that's what you would do. And if you choose to, for some of them, you may actually have to go all the way through, but you can just be the judge of that. I think I went all the way through, but it's okay. And once you take it apart, there's like no going back unless you just recurl that one, recoil that one, should I say. But I love how this looks already. I love how this looks. Okay, so like I said, just be careful when you're pulling your hair apart for breakage, and just so you don't just do too much and have frizz. The more you do this, you will start to see your hair get fuller and you will start to love it. Like, I really love this step. Okay guys, so another thing I want to say is you can do this with some oil on your hand, but as you all know, when I'm not doing hair, I'm dancing. So I have African dance tonight, and it's just going to make my hair so frizzy if I put oil on it today. So I'm not putting anything on my hair, but in the morning I will. I actually don't like to put oil on my hair at night because it usually, you know, it can seep onto my pillowcase through my bonnet or scarf, and some oils just break my face out. And I can't be walking around here like that. Okay, y'all, so this here is the final part. Okay guys, so as you can see, I did my baby bangs, and now I'm going to pick my roots with my wide tooth comb. I like to use the comb instead of a pick because the edges of the comb, they're a little more round and they don't snag, and I feel like a pick, because it's metal and the ends are a little sharper, it can cause breakage to your hair. Sometimes I do use a pick, but today, especially right after I wash my hair, I never use a pick. So yeah, I'm just going to take the comb and bring it up to almost the end of my hair, and then I'm going to release the comb. So yeah, that's what I'm going to do for my whole head. So you have to be cautious, because if you put this comb all the way through, listen to you, girl, your hair gonna be messed up. Your hair gonna be messed up, y'all. I don't mean to laugh, but ask me how I know, and ask me why I'm laughing. I've been there. And so if you want volume like in the middle, it's good to put the comb behind your curls, like underneath, and pull it up. And I'm gonna say if you pull it through, it'll be messed up, but you won't have the ends looking like this. So you just have to be very cautious, because sometimes when we're rushing, we can mess up, make a little mistake. Oh my gosh, I just love this, guys. To me, it just looks so much better in person than even what the camera is giving. And it's still shiny. So you probably noticed that the front of my hair is short. You know why? I was taking out my crochet braids. And I made a mistake and cut my hair. The hair looks so much like my hair. I literally thought it was my hair. So that's the story on why that's so sharp, but you know, I always have a trick up my sleeves to fix that as well. Natural hair is just so amazing. I love it, okay? I love it. Don't be worrying about people talking about, oh, your hair nappy. No, it is not. Do you see this beauty? Do you not see this beauty? Okay, so you can pick your fro out as much as you want. You can just continue this process, but I'm really not doing anything today. I'm just going to keep it just like this. See this one here? I don't know why it's just, so I'm just going to separate it. Like I said, some of them you'll probably have to separate, but mostly if you want this clean little look like this, don't separate. So as I told y'all, I was going to do something to the front, and usually what I do is take two bobby pins and crisscross them under here, because your girl don't have much hang time, unfortunately, right there. And when I tell y'all, this is progress right here. When I tell y'all it was up here, yes, it really was. I just couldn't believe I cut my hair, and not just that, the next time I did a style, because I feel like I'm always rushing, I clipped a whole section right here out of my edges. Yeah, so thank God they are growing back slowly. Well, since I haven't been putting weave or tension around my edges much, I feel like it's starting to grow fast. So yeah, I've been starting to take care of my hair even more lately. So yeah, it's pretty cool. So yeah, I'll probably take some cute pics for you all. And I definitely want to show y'all various styles, so I will do that later. But I did get some headbands so I can put in my hair. And as you saw, I have this scarf, which can also be, you know, a little headband or wrap or something. So I want to show you those styles when we come back from the gym, because my husband and I are about to go work out. So yes, I'll see y'all then. Okay guys, this is the final result. This is my curls. Here are my coils. The final results here. Hopefully you can see the back pretty well. And shrinkage is amazing. I know we'd be trying to run from it, but as long as your hair shrinks right back up, you know, you don't have that much heat damage. Even though some people with heat damage, they can get coils, but they would be loose. So the best thing is to keep the heat out of your hair as much as you can. Okay. And so with that being said, y'all continue to watch my videos. I'll be showing y'all a few styles in another video. So that will probably be the next video. And I'll show you a little one right now. This is one of my favorite headbands I got from Claire's. I'm just going to put it on like this. Got some hair there. You can even tuck your sides in if you want to. If I do this, baby, that would be slick, okay? But for the sake of the video and time, just imagine, okay? Yeah, I know some people would like to have a little bang out in the front, but my hair is short right here, so I just think it looks better with something out on the sides. But I really do like how this style looks with a headband, so you can just have a little versatility even with short hair. So definitely get you some scarves and some accessories for your hair. I even have these. Be cautious with these little clips because they could pull your hair out, but I would like put one side back. Of course, it's not slick, but you can imagine, like, just putting one side back and where it'll probably look something like this. So it's like a mohawk. Or if you don't want the whole mohawk, you can just do just this side back, and you see there's hair still back there. So yeah, I'll come in another video and slay all of these styles for you, okay? So thank you so much for watching. If you're not a subscriber, go ahead and subscribe to my channel and tell your friends about it. If you have short hair or you need your coils popping, then continue to watch, because I will be doing this whole journey since I basically big chopped again. I'll be taking you on a journey with me. So thank you guys. I love you all. Jesus love you too. And yes, I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Okay guys, I just wanted to share this clip of my client. She got some coils and it came out very cute. She got a beautiful side part and she loved it, and I've used the same technique. The only thing, I just used the green gel and some olive oil. Cute.